Here in Unity, gonna open a new scene. I'm not gonna save these scenes, so it's just so I have a clean workspace to work from. The first thing I wanna do is I wanna have a folder with my company name in it, just as a place to keep assets together. My company's Peppergum Games, so I have a Peppergum folder. And I'm gonna bring in some FBXs. I have this Penguin FBX with its texture. I drag it into my folder, and after importing here for a minute, it shows up. I can now bring that in to a game, which we're not doing quite yet. I have a couple other assets. I have this truck. This is a 3DS, but we can treat it the same as an FBX. So that first penguin was an FBX. This truck and its texture are not. It doesn't have any animation in it. And then this bug bot and texture, that's another FBX. So now I've drug in three different models with their accompanying textures. So that just means they're now in my project. They're going to be saved in the app if I use them anywhere. Now I need to build a prefab that is basically what's going to come up when any particular texture is detected. So I'm gonna drag this bug bot in to my scene and let him go. And whenever I drag a mesh in, I usually go over here to its transform on the right, and I do a reset from this top right gear, do a reset on the transform, and that just makes sure he's positioned at 0, 0, 0, with his rotation at 0, 0, 0 and the identity matrix on the scale. So if I just need to use this guy, just have him show up on a target. I have a special folder structure that'll make that automatic. So here under resources, I'm down here in the project tab. I expand resources, and then I have under it. So under structured content, I'm going to select structured content, and then up here at the top of this panes, select create folder, and I'm going to name it BugBot. All lowercase. And then if I just drag, well, it's easier to do from over here. So here's my FBX. If I'll just drag that in to this BugBot folder. So I grab my FBX, dropping it in the folder. And what's important in here is that the folder BugBot has the informational name, but I need to name this something that my script will find. And I'm going to just name this prefab. I know that sounds a little bit generic, but it's not because it's underneath the folder name that carries all the information it needs. Similarly, down here, you'll see that this folder structure does something else. It doesn't call up an augmentation. But computer has a prefab that if I pull it up, that's what we're showing over the computer target. That's just an example. When the dinosaur target is found, it's a rounded capsule, and so on. So this guy I can now delete. I mean, I don't need to save the scene. Just if I go new scene, there's nothing I need to save. Don't save. And what happens is down in structured content, the BugBot prefab, because of some script I wrote, will be called up anytime a target named BugBot is found. And we can look at how that works here in a sec. Let's say I have multiple scenes that have. Let me show you how to make a more flexible prefab now. So I'm in an empty scene again, and this time I'm going to create an empty game object. I came up here to the game object in the top menu and create empty. It really just gave me a node. See this? I just have this empty object that just has a transform. I'll do reset on the transform again, like I did before, in this gear in the top right. Now, what I can do is I can bring stuff in there and have it parented. So I'm going to go into my Peppergum company folder, where just my raw FBXs and stuff are. And I think I want to have a penguin. Let me select that and drag up my penguin to be childed in there. And And also my hover truck to be childed in there. They are vastly different sides. Even though I drag them into this game object, I'm gonna, on both of them, when I do it one at a time or together, same as before, select them, and then on the transform element, I'm gonna reset. Now they're both at 0, 0. These guys have a much different scales, so I'm going to, yeah, that truck's way too big. I'm gonna scale that truck down here. Probably 0.01 is more. This is just if you want your scale rotation or whatever to work in your scene. All right, so I've got my truck here. My penguin, he doesn't have his skin on, so I'm just gonna drop his texture on. And I want him to be looking at the truck. Great. And I think I want him to be bigger, even with the truck being smaller. So I'm adjusting that over here in his transform. All right, I kind of like that. The truck seems to be a little below the pane, and it's a hover truck, so I can hover that off the ground a bit. All right, this scene makes some sense to me now. Penguin and truck. Okay, so this game object, this top level node, which was empty, it really is apparent for the truck and the penguin. That is the thing that I'm now going to rename. Well, here, let's start. We'll do this one step at a time. I'm going to actually select that. I hit enter. Name it prefab. And then the steps are the same as before. I go down to resources, structured content, and I just make another folder in here like we did before. Select structured content, and at the top of the pane, select create folder. And I think this augmentation might be called new truck. So remember what the name of the folder is for? It's going to match a marker we find in any. Anyway, so prefab goes inside a new truck folder. So this prefab, which is both of these things together, goes in the new truck. Let me show you how that works. File, new scene. Remember, we don't have anything to save here. And don't save anything. We have this new truck prefab. I'm going to quickly make another empty game object. And if we're in person, I'd challenge you to do this. But now I'm going to do a little bit of reuse. So that bug bot I used before, which is in my company folder, I'm bringing the bug bot in here. And I'm bringing in the truck. And that truck I'm going to scale down again. I could have reset his position. I think I can just say reset position. Great. Oh, I left his Y large. Great. I just copied those in wrong. So I've got this truck, and he's going to be positioned a little differently. He's going to be rotated funny because he's sort of peeling out, trying to get away from the bug bot. And this bot is he's just turning to fire. It's a pretty sweet little scene. You'll notice I neglected to parent them under game objects, so I can drag them in here over on the higher in the hierarchy pane. So truck is under game object, bug bot is under game object. Now they're all parented together, so anything I do to game object affects them. The transforms, the matrices percolate down. So I'm renaming this prefab. And coming down to resources, structured content, selecting structured content, creating a new folder. And this is going to be called truck escape. And then I bring. Oh, I accidentally put truck escape inside a network. So I can easily just delete that folder. Select structured content, create folder. Great. All lowercase, naming it truck escape. I can spell that right. Great. And I drag prefab into truck escape. All right, so whenever I find a target name. All right, if you want to see, let me show you how this is th then going to be used. I'm going into a scene that I don't want any of you necessarily to go into, but I'm opening general metaverse AR scene. And it has a collection of AR targets, and you'll see that each of them has the name of a folder down below. Viewfinder, dinosaur, computer, versus, education, call. I would then myself make more targets for the ones we found. Y'all don't need to do that. That's something I'm going to do. But that just kind of shows why we're naming the folders what we are. But again, don't add anything in this scene. If you want to test, you go to test scene and I have this viewfinder Vuforia image target. I'm going to rename this. I'm going to reset this to a living pop-ups viewfinder target. This is just for testing. But let's say I wanted. Well, let me show you before I even use that. I want to show you what we made with our prefabs now. Under, sorry, I'm trying to go to resources, structured content. We made a bugbot prefab. If I pull that in, there's a bugbot standing alone. We made a n new truck prefab. I pull that in, it's the penguin looking at the truck. And we made a truck escape prefab. If I pull that in, I've got the bot and the truck. What I want you to see here is that we can make, and I only put two in these scenes, but you could put three, five, ten, however many you needed. I just wanted to show you that you can have your FBX not duplicated in memory. That's just in my company folder, is where there's one of each FBX. But because I made prefabs referencing those, these are just references, not duplicated meshes in memory. Anyway, because we made the prefabs in the step we did, each of these separate augmentations will be pulled up on the correspondingly named image target. So that's how you get your content into this project structure, and that's a little heads up on how to use prefabs to mix and match meshes. And then I can also set individual animations on these meshes. So this penguin. Let me make sure I have the penguin selected over here. This penguin, if I go to his animation layer, I can set his animation to be excited when he's looking at the truck, and or makes more sense over here. This bug bot might just be doing an idle animation, whereas the bug bot in this prefab I can set to be firing, to be firing on the truck. Let me know if you have any questions, but this should let you get all your content in starting today.